Whenever you install a Windows program into CrossOver, it goes into a bottle. Bottles are a series of folders that CrossOver generates that have the same layout as a Windows C drive. Each bottle also has a registry file and claims to be a particular version of Windows. When you begin to install a program in CrossOver, all of this information is passed on to your application installer so that it can figure out where different files go. All of this bottle stuff happens automatically when you install a Windows program in CrossOver. That's usually the end of the story, but there are a few cases where knowing more about bottles can save you time later on. Let's start by showing how you can see and choose between different bottles in CrossOver. First, launch CrossOver, then click on the bottle icon in the top left of the window. The list that appears are the bottles in CrossOver. You can select a bottle and CrossOver will display only the applications in that particular bottle. You can run different bottle commands by using the buttons in bottom left of the window, up in the bottle menu, or by right-clicking a bottle. A common question is, how do you remove a Windows application from CrossOver? You delete the bottle that contains the Windows app. Just select the bottle and press the minus button in the lower left to remove it. When the bottle is gone, the Windows application is gone. Programs in different bottles can't interact or affect each other. So if you need to remove one bottle, it won't mess up any other bottles or Windows programs you have installed in CrossOver. By default, CrossOver will create a new bottle for anything you try to install. However, in some cases you may need to install into an existing bottle. Let's say, for example, you've downloaded a patch which you need to apply a Windows program already in CrossOver. To do this, first select a bottle, and under the gear button pick Install Software Into the name of the bottle. This will begin the regular software install process and the patcher will find the existing Windows program to try and update. You can also access the files in the bottle directly by selecting Open C Drive under the gear button. That will open a new Finder window to root level of the bottle. There are a few other areas to look at quickly. First, CrossOver has the ability to backup and restore bottles. This is useful if you want to migrate from one computer to another and don't want to have to reinstall everything in CrossOver on a new machine. Select a bottle and pick Export, whatever the bottle name is, to Archive, from the gear button. You can also import a bottle by going to the bottle menu up in the menu bar and choosing Import Bottle Archive. Finally, each bottle has a control panel section that some Windows programs, like Outlook, might add their own control panel to. There is also a settings menu under the gear button which flips some of the registry keys on the bottle. It's pretty rare to need to use either of these areas, they're mostly for troubleshooting with tech support. So that's a quick overview of what bottles are in CrossOver and some basic things you can do with them. Thanks for watching.